I think still if you Google black and white ballet kissing goals, it comes up, which is funny. Such a specific thing to Google. I'm vlogging more consistently, which is amazing, especially for me. But because I'm doing it more consistently, I want a banner on my YouTube page that looks better. As you YouTubers know, updating your banner is kind of a pain in the butt. So I was poking around at some people's pages to see what they did. So I stalked my friend Olivia Tarchik's page to see what she did, and she had this great, like, collage of photos. They look fantastic. I didn't take those photos, but that's okay. We're gonna let it slide. So I'm gonna try and emulate that and do kind of like a collage of me. So I just looked through my iPhone in my favorites folder and found a bunch of photos of myself, and then I airdropped them to my computer. This image has been around the internet like 10,000 times. That's me and my wife, Nicole, who you guys see in these vlogs all the time, when we were both students at the San Francisco Ballet School. That was, I think, minutes before we went on stage in what would be our final performance together. We're actually in a hallway in Yerba Buena Center for the Arts in San Francisco, which is kind of by the Metreon. And I gave my sister Lilith, who was also in the school at the time, my iPhone 1 and was like, please take a picture. So she snaps the photo, like I said, in the hallway, like fluorescent lighting. It is not an epic scene. But she crushed it, got the shot super well. I wanna say I even just used like a filter on iPhone. I remember just hitting black and white and it turning into that masterpiece.
So then I upload that photo to this little website called Facebook, which at the time was nowhere near what it is today.
Then years go by. I don't think about the image, Nicole doesn't think about the image, and my sister doesn't think about the image. I can't remember who it was. One of us stumbled upon it on Tumblr, if you guys remember that website. And it had millions of reposts and people commenting, trying to figure out who the two dancers were in the image. And we were like, wow, that's crazy, because we never uploaded it to Tumblr. I only uploaded it to my private Facebook account, which means someone that I was friends with took that image and put it on Tumblr, which is a little funny. So then more time goes by, just see it pop up here and there. Also find it all over Pinterest. I think still if you Google black and white ballet kissing goals, it comes up, which is funny. Such a specific thing to Google. So a couple years ago on Valentine's Day, I took it upon myself to post that image on the Ballet Zeta Instagram and explain the story of it.
So that's a fantastic image that we just got that whole spiel about. What other images have I selected to be in the banner? Oh, me in my living room, definitely as iconic. Ooh, me walking in the airport. So this says I travel in airports and I use a roller bag, and my walking in an image kind of looks like I might be Bigfoot. And then this one of a lens was on this shoot, I think, with Lindsay Fulton. She noticed that this lens specifically really reflects light in this really cool, like, bokeh-y kind of way. All right, now we're gonna see how it looks with me walking in the airport added. We got those three. Kind of looks like I'm walking towards myself. Yeah, don't like that placement. What if we put that one over there? That's already better. Okay, now we're making them smaller so we can fit kind of like all of them in. There's just more to look at and it comes at you with that collage effect more. Now we've got our four images together. So now I'm experimenting with text. We've got Ballet Zeta, kind of that slight blue there, Films and Blondes, which is kind of weird because it's all on that side of the four. I feel like something needs to be over here, kind of even that out. So let's try putting my name. And now we've got my name in there, but it's too weird, right? Too low, maybe higher. Still looks super weird.
I feel like this is my process with much of photography. Does it look weird? Kind of.
All right, so we're uploading the image to YouTube. Let's see how it looks. Okay, okay, interesting. Not the absolute worst. I would prefer if my face was more in that pink one, but that looks nice over there. Those two look really good. Those two are not as strong, but it's stronger than it was. Let's see how it looks on the telephone. Okay, so that looks pretty much just terrible on the phone. See, this is why it's so difficult to do this. We basically need to move everything into the black and white and the shot of me for all that text to be visible on both the phone and the desktop. Which means it's gonna be a lot smaller. What are you gonna do? All right, this is our new one. So I moved the text to just the black and white, made it way smaller, moved that text to just the shot of me in the hallway. Blammo, see how that goes. Should work, because we're in the frame. Once again, I wish my face was a little more in it, but it's okay. Mysterious. All right, moment of truth. Okay, not bad. Not bad at all. I'm pretty satisfied with that. Let's see how it looks on the telephone. So here was the old one, see the new one. Okay, the text is correctly placed. I dig it. It's got a bit more of a collage-y vibe.